Hey folks, thank you for tuning in for another Elden Ring boss guide. This time we're talking about Mohg. Now we are here at Mohg's palace in his area where he has Mikola over there. You can see Mikola in his little egg womb thing. Yeah, that's where he is. But you're going to see a cutscene here. You probably have already seen the cutscene yourself, but I'm going to let it play out while I describe the fight a little bit here, okay? This fight is something that you can do very early on in the game if you choose to, but I choose to take it on late game because the fight can actually be pretty tough. The good news about this fight is Mohg doesn't have a whole lot of resistances to a whole lot of things here. The version you find of him in the subterranean shunning grounds is just a projection of him, so you don't have a whole lot of like elemental or status effects that are useful against him there. But here, he's very weak to bleed, frostbite, you can use poison and scarlet rot on him as well. All that stuff is applicable in this arena against Mohg, because this is the actual real version of him. He does have two phases. So I'm going to describe the first phase real quick. If you do have Mohg Shackle, you can use it twice during this phase. That is a possibility for you. So if you do have it, don't be afraid to use it, because it just binds him to the ground and allows you to get a few free hits on him. And in fact, if you are struggling with this fight, I would recommend doing so. The next thing that you need to worry about is when he transitions to phase two. The curse that he applies to you is a blade curse. So if you do have, if you have done the fight against Eleonora, not only do you get her pole blade, but you get the purifying red crystal as well. The purifying crystal makes it so it negates majority of the damage from that phase transition. So I would say make sure you have that equipped on your flask. If you don't have it, be prepared to use a ton of your crimson flask to outheal the damage that applies here. I would say if you don't have it, make sure you go to the Second Church of Marika, defeat Eleonora, get that red crystal, equip it, and it'll make the transition of this a lot easier, because then you'll also be able to hit him for a whole bunch of damage and negate a good amount of his healing. Now, the first phase is essentially identical to the entire fight that you can find of him in the subterranean shunning grounds, so that's the easier part of this. The second phase, he has a whole bunch of blood flame that he throws everywhere, and it does a ton of damage really quickly. Not to mention it leaves fire everywhere that can apply bleed like crazy as well, so be ready to avoid all those areas on the ground as much as you possibly can. Ouch. There's some more blood flame right there, that's what I mean. So let's go ahead and use the shackle. This only works in the first half of the fight, so you need to be very sure that you use it in the first half of the fight as much as possible. Let's tie him to the ground again. Oh, you can't do it while he's doing the curse. Tie him to the ground again. Hit him a bunch for damage. Use your flask, because now he's going to do the curse. And then I like to get behind him and just hit him a whole bunch. You can see that the damage I just applied negated all of his healing that he just did there, and now he's below half health. There he jumps in the sky, throws blood at you, and then comes down on you, starts throwing blood everywhere. You just gotta try to find an open window to heal. Outside of that, it's more of the same, just dodging his combos, making sure you're not getting hit by all of those swings like crazy. Just taking it very slow, very methodical. Just trying everything you can to not get hit by all this blood flame as much as possible. You will find moments to attack in between all this stuff. You just gotta be a little patient for it, that's all. You see what I mean? Keep dodging this stuff, and then you get wide open areas to attack him. He actually like doesn't attack you for large amounts of time, so you're able to land a whole bunch of damage whenever he's not attacking you. I like to dodge to the right on that, but sometimes I just fail miserably, like so. Oh, I failed my roll. Let's avoid that. I probably should have just dodged, but I wanted to heal through it just in case that I failed my roll. Oh, I rolled a little early, but that's okay. Keep in mind that in the middle of a lot of his blood flame claw attacks, he will try to hit you with a swing immediately after. So you need to make sure that you play it a little bit on the safer side there. Try not to get hit by it. Just don't attack immediately after one of the blood flame claw attacks. Just take it easy. Focus on the dodge. Try to stay close to him as much as possible. Let him swing away. Use those wide open opportunities to land your attacks. And that's Mohg, Lord of Blood. It can be a very tough fight, but as long as you pace yourself and you attack in the right moments, you can really simplify this fight. What a lot of people will do, and this is a major mistake, is they will attack in the middle of his combos. When you attack in the middle of Mohg's combos, it just makes you take damage because you can't dodge while you're attacking a lot of the time. You have to wait for the animation. So as long as you play it patient and wait for those wide open windows that he gives you to really apply your damage, it really simplifies the fight, like I said. Anyways, dudes, I hope this video does help you. I know it can be tough, but you just got to remember, keep it patient, roll at the right times, and counterattack in those wide open windows. With that said, I'm out of here for now. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing, and I'll see you soon for more.